U.S. President Joe Biden is confident Sweden will soon be part of NATO. That's despite Turkey and Hungary's continued opposition to the Northern European country's accession to the alliance. Speaking at the Air Force Academy graduation ceremony, Biden also praised NATO's unity amid Russia's invasion of Ukraine. His remarks come days after Secretary of State Antony Blinken urged Turkey to approve Sweden's bid to become a NATO member.
NATO is more energized and more united than it's been in decades. It's now even stronger with the accession of our newest ally, Finland, and soon Sweden, and the alliance as soon as possible.
Meanwhile, in a headline-grabbing moment, the 80-year-old American president tripped on a sandbag and fell after handing out the last diploma at the ceremony. The White House assured the public the president is fine, with Biden himself making light of the gaffe afterwards. The U.S. debt limit bill now up for President Joe Biden's signature. That's after the Senate passed the bill with a vote of 63-36. This comes a day after the House of Representatives passed the bipartisan bill, which suspends the debt ceiling for 2 years. Lawmakers were racing to pass the legislation before June 5, the date when the Treasury Department said it would no longer be able to pay the nation's obligations. The measure was approved after months of haggling and resistance from hardline Republicans. Biden praised Congress for voting to protect America's hard-earned economic progress, calling it a big win for America. But the president said the work is far from finished, and he vows to sign the bill into law as soon as possible. Good news for U.S. visa applicants. The waiting time for visa appointments has significantly improved, with the U.S. Embassy on track to process over 300,000 applications this year. More from Zen Hernandez.
Over 1,000 visa applicants go to the U.S. Embassy in Manila daily, which is why it was quite challenging for its consular section to process applications during the COVID-19 pandemic. The number of staff was affected, causing the number of visas issued to drop to 190,000 from a high of 290,000 in 2019. Consequently, there was a backlog and a visa appointment wait time of almost 2 years. Joanne and her family experienced this firsthand, but luckily, the U.S. Embassy opened earlier slots and their wait time was reduced from over 1 year to 9 months. Now, they have their visa.
Since pandemic, diba, alam naman natin lahat na hindi tayo nakapag-travel. For the family, ba, ma-enjoy especially ng mga kids na makapunta sa ibang lugar.
As the pandemic challenges eased, visa processing at the U.S. Embassy improved tremendously. Wait times are currently 4 to 5 months and expected to improve further to 2 to 3 months. And this year, the U.S. Embassy consular section is on track to processing up to 325,000 visas.
We have worked very hard to improve our efficiency, to make the process as smooth and easy as possible, and to make it as painless as possible, to allow for as much capacity as we can handle for the Philippine public to apply for visas to travel to the United States.
There were also significant policy changes, including expanding the allowable period for visa renewal from 1 year to 4 years after expiration. Minors who are also previous visa holders and over 14 years of age may renew without an interview by getting an appointment for biometrics. Interviews are also waived for those over 79 years old. For visa applicants, however, the U.S. Embassy has this very simple advice.
Number one, always tell the truth. We can often tell really quickly when people are not being truthful.
Aside from non-immigrant visas, there's also an increase in work visas being issued by the U.S. Embassy. From October 2021 to September 2022, over 77,000 visas were processed for Filipino ship and airline crew members. The U.S. Embassy Consular Section also noted increasing visa applications for healthcare professionals hired by American employers. Zen Hernandez, ABS-CBN News.
Kyiv launching a probe into the deaths of three people outside a bomb shelter. The 9-year-old girl, her mother, and another woman died when rocket debris fell near the shelter they had been trying to enter. Kyiv Mayor Vitaly Klitschko said the entrance to the shelter was reportedly blocked. According to local residents, the victims knocked loudly enough, but no one opened the door for them. President Volodymyr Zelensky has expressed frustration at the miscue and warns local officials unable to provide protection could be prosecuted. European leaders vow to remain united in the face of Russia's aggression. At least 45 leaders gathered for a strategy summit in the vulnerable country of Moldova, with the event's venue located just 12 miles from the border with war-torn Ukraine. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky also joined the summit, seeking to keep up pressure for concrete support ahead of his country's expected counteroffensive against Russia. He reiterated calls for Western fighter jets to protect Ukrainian skies from yet another Russian attack. Inflation in the Eurozone falls to its lowest pace since Russia invaded Ukraine. The rise in consumer prices in Europe eased to 6.1% in May from 7% in April. That's the lowest rate since February 2022, and it was mainly driven by slower increases in food prices, while energy prices actually fell. This gives the European Central Bank a reason to pause interest rate hikes soon. The ECB has increased interest rates by 375 basis points in less than a year. Sri Lanka is on a path to recovery. That's according to President Ranil Wickremesinghe. He said inflation, which reached 70%, has gone down to 25.2%. And in a sign of confidence that the worst is over, the central bank surprised markets by cutting interest rates for the first time in 3 years. The South Asian nation was plunged into crisis last year as its foreign exchange reserves ran out, food and energy prices spiraled, and protests forced the ouster of the country's then president. Meta reveals the company's next-generation mixed reality headset as the company braces for Apple's entry into a market that Meta has dominated so far. The Quest 3 is 40% thinner than the company's previous offering and features color mixed reality, which combines AR and VR elements. It will be powered by a new Qualcomm chipset with twice the graphics performance as the Quest 2. The device will launch in the autumn with prices starting at $499. On Monday, Apple is expected to announce its rumored Reality Pro headset at WWDC, which would be its first new major product line in nearly a decade. Fictional monster the Boogeyman takes on a new form in a new film. Yong Chavez talks to the lead star Sophie Thatcher about how the upcoming adaptation will tackle themes of grief.
The short story that made readers have nightmares when the light is off, where the monsters can be lurking in closets, is now on the big screen in The Boogeyman. Horror master Stephen King wrote the original story that became the basis for the horror thriller film. The story revolves around Sadie, a teenager whose family is devastated by grief after the loss of her mother. The Boogeyman feeds on grief and suffering. Rising Hollywood star Sophie Thatcher plays Sadie. The actress has also gained notice for her acclaimed TV series Yellow Jackets.
This is a character who has such tremendous grief after losing her mother. What was it like inhabiting this character?
It was definitely heavy, and she's in such a distinct stage of grief that I think is very different from other stages because she's so keen on becoming closer with her mom, even though she can't She's just really trying to get to know her mom better and feel like she's a friend to her, so she's so hyper-fixated on that that she's disconnected from everything else. So I think just, like, focusing on that and focusing on the importance of her mom's belongings and trying to, like, replicate that feeling of intimacy.
The actress had to deliver not only on the emotional scenes, but also on the rigorous demands of the film's action scenes.
You also had a lot of physical scenes, right? I mean, what was that like filming that?
I keep getting cast in projects where I do a lot of stunts, and I have never been like an outdoorsy or, and I've never been like an athletic person at all, but it's something that you just have to learn, and you have to learn to be very in tune with your body as an actor, or else it just doesn't translate. So I think projects like this have really helped me, because you just have to be like very in tune with your breath work and in tune with your body. It's very physically draining, and I think halfway through I was like, okay, I can't go days without wearing knee pads.
The Boogeyman also stars Chris Messina and Vivian Lara Blair. Yong Chavez, ABS-CBN News, here in Hollywood.